I've been asked a number of times about the recipe for the garlic bread, and there is no proper recipe as such. It's my version, my made up version, and I have two versions here for you, two recipes. So of garlic bread one and garlic bread two. This one here is made using the first recipe, and the first recipe is made with soda bread flour, a teaspoonful of garlic powder, a teaspoonful of mixed herbs, and I've mixed all together. I mixed all together using buttermilk, made it into a dough, flattened it out on a baking tray and baked it for about 15 minutes. Then whenever it was just starting to brown, I took it out of the oven and I poured over the top of it melted butter with some of this smoked lazy garlic in it and put it back into the oven until it had crisped up. So it's a really good, nice garlic bread. So the second version, which is in the oven now, is made with plain flour and baking powder. So that's because I have plain flour and I need a raisin agent in it. I didn't need a raisin agent with the soda bread flour. And I've added again the same basic ingredients. I've added a teaspoonful of garlic, teaspoonful of mixed herbs. And I've binded it all together with buttermilk. And it's now in the oven cooking. So I've cut that first one in half, so you can see what it looks like. It's a nice springy soft dough. And later on in the week I'm going to make pizza, and I'll do it exactly like this, except I'll put cheese and whatever else on top of it. So that's the first one, the one made with the soda bread flour, and that's what it looks like. So this is garlic bread recipe number two, made using the plain flour and the baking powder, and it's just out of the oven and it's equally as nice as the first one. So you can make these recipes your own. There's no right and no wrong way. You can put extra garlic into it. You can use lazy garlic or even fresh garlic, which is even better. You can use as much herbs or as little as you want. And the same, I've used garlic powder. You don't have to use that. So make the recipe your own. So I've cut both garlic breads. This is recipe number one and this is recipe number two. And there really is no difference at all. And they both taste equally as nice.